What's up, real ones? Welcome back to the Realationship Podcast, episode number 10.
Yes, sir.
I'm Asha Steele.
And I'm Devin Steele.
And we are so excited that you guys are still tuning in with us.
Yeah, because it's been long overdue. We've been going for a long time. We've been getting a lot of you guys DMs and emails telling us that we needed to get back on doing this podcast. But to be honest with you, it's been a lot going on. Yeah. And I know a lot of you have been experiencing it. Just with this whole pandemic going on, and you know, our life was flipped upside down, like I'm sure a lot of you guys were, and we just felt the need that we needed to get our house in order before we hop on the mic and try to share some, you know, tips and tricks on how to create a real relationship. Mm-hmm. We just wanted to make sure that we had everything in order as far as our finances, our relationship, you know, welcoming our new child. That's been, let me tell you, that's probably been one of the hardest things, is just learning how to navigate and, you know, just be able to accomplish things while dealing with a newborn.
Yeah, I think for me, it's been a huge adjustment. And like you said, it kind of put a strain, I feel like, also on our relationship, just because it was just like,
God, I see her every day.
So unknown. Not,
all day.
No, not just that, but it's just like, everything's so unknown. Everything's like just up in the air. Our normal is no longer our normal. So just trying to have a balance, trying to create a schedule, realign things, whether it be from work, from school, just taking care of the household, children. It's just like everything was in shambles. And I feel like it was causing a lot of tension and stress. So like you said, we kind of had to reevaluate our lives, get our lives back together, get back on the track, because, you know, we want to present y'all with the real. So the real is we was all over the place, child. We was a mess.
Struggling. And we tried to record multiple episodes for months, right? But it was like we would try to put Aria to sleep, and then we'll get 20 minutes into an episode.
And she's up.
She'll just start crying. We'll see her on the baby monitor. We got to drop everything and go attend to her. So
then
today,
you have to worry about his schedule. You're doing things. My schedule is doing things around the house. It was just a lot.
But check this out. We gave Aria, I don't know how much cereal mixed in with her food today. So she's out, y'all.
Like,
we're going to be able to get this podcast done. And if this works, she's getting cereal every afternoon and every night so we can get things done.
Okay, so we can give y'all that content. But, like, just from your own, you know, experience and what we've been going through, what's been keeping your mind, you know, kind of clear or keeping you sane, if you can say that, during this time?
I feel like I've been insane.
Oh, my goodness.
To be completely honest with you, like I said, you know, as the man of the household, I try to focus a lot on making sure that we're financially stable. Mm-hmm. And since retiring from the NFL, one of the main ways that I've been able to generate money for our household was traveling, doing consulting, speaking at corporate events. And since the pandemic hit, I haven't done any traveling, right? I had to stop all that. I've turned down invitations to speak at corporate events because I want to make sure that I'm protecting my health and protecting my family's health. So that, in a sense, stop a stream of revenue.
Right.
So I've been trying to focus on ways that I can still generate that revenue for the house so that we're still financially stable during this crisis, which it's been stressful. But as, you know, time went on, I've been able to find ways to really take what I was doing on stage and really bring it to a virtual sense to, you know, impact these companies. So that's been pretty tough. So since I've got the hang of that, just, you know, working out for me has always been something that relieves stress. So just working out constantly every single day has alleviated a lot of my stress, just, you know, dealing with everything that's going on in the world.
That seems like it's a good reliever. I think for me, I've been doing a lot more, or at least trying to get a little bit more in tune with myself. One thing being, I love music, so listening to music, trying to go with my mood for the day to see how I'm feeling, so that can kind of like carry me throughout the day and keep my mind at peace. Because
see, you just gave me some tips.
What?
I need to check your iTunes app to see what music you listening to every day to know what type of day I'm going to have. Because if it's
so
some crazy stuff,
clue.
I'm getting out the house.
Like if I wake up listening to something off the wall, you want to know, stay clear of me.
Yeah, so we're going to be checking that.
So I think doing that and just, you know, I started recently jotting down, making a little journal, jotting down thoughts in my experiences being a new mom throughout this year and just things that I've been going through, changes in my life with my career change and everything that I've been doing. So I just feel like I've just been documenting things, kind of like just trying to, you know, have this little, this moment in time, because I feel like 2020 already, especially with the pandemic, has been like so unreal. And I feel like it was something that we read about in our history books and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And never thought that we would actually live.
I didn't read about my history books because I didn't read my textbooks.
Oh my goodness.
I didn't start doing that till I went to grad school.
But it was
honest moment.
You know what? I can't. But seriously, like, it was something that I felt like we wouldn't have experienced for our own selves. And just living through something, a world crisis like this, is just so surreal. It's mind-blowing. And so I've just been really trying to, like, jot down my experiences so that I have a moment in time to just look back and reflect on what I was doing and how I changed during this time.
Yeah. Before we jump into our topic for this episode, why don't you touch on a little bit more of being a new mom during the pandemic? Because I know we've had talks about things that you, when you were carrying Aria, things that you were looking forward to do her first year of her being born, but you haven't been able to do any of that because of COVID. So touch on it a little bit more of some of the things that you've been experiencing for all the other new moms out there who may be listening.
So to be honest, it's been exciting, but it's been very stressful. I know before I had talked a little bit about, I don't know if it was on my social media or maybe on a podcast, but I talked a little bit about how I wanted to, you know, be there to experience her first, like her first time crawling or her first time talking or walking and everything like that. And so jumping back into my career at the time, I felt like I was stealing that or robbing that from myself, you know. And so it was very important for me to have those experiences with her and just to see her grow and develop, because this first year of life, I feel like is very crucial, and it's very like it means a lot because they develop so fast and so many changes happen. And it's just like, oh my goodness, like she was just like a little baby that just came out of me. And now she's like crawling and trying to get into everything. So just being able to experience that and not like miss those moments has been very important to me. So that's one positive I can say that came out of the pandemic, that is just like, you know, I get
being
to have that experience.
All the time.
Yeah, I get to have that experience. But it's also hard because we're stuck in Houston, like we can't travel, and all of our family is back on the East Coast. So it's just like we don't get to see them. They don't get to have those experiences with us to see her grow and develop and be there for her first birthday coming up. So that's been really hard for me as well, because I want to be able to share those moments with our family. And unfortunately, we can't do that. So it's kind of like the best of both worlds. Like I get to have all this time with her, but I don't get to share that time with other people. So
yeah, that's tough. And I'm pretty sure most of you guys do this. We try to use, you know, FaceTime and Skype as much as possible to stay connected with our family.
And now she thinks our phones
is
her phone.
Oh, man, let this phone go off. She'll run to the phone talking about something. Hello?
Yes.
Hey,
all the time. That's all she want to do.
Yeah, she think the phone is hers. But technology has really helped us stay connected, because like Asha said, we live in Houston. All our family is up and down the East Coast. So we haven't, this has been the longest I've been without seeing my family, which is tough.
Too.
And Aria turns one at the end of this month, and our family probably saw her 2 times.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's like always that, is she going to know her grandma? Is she going to know her grandpa? Is she going to know her family, because she hasn't been around them? But hopefully, you know, technology transfers over to when she sees them in person and, you know, she knows who they are. But we're just trying to make the best out of the situation, like I'm sure a lot of you guys are.
Right, yeah. And I think that's pretty much kind of like going into this, the way of the world now with technology. It seems like that's how we are moving forward in life with communicating, which is a little bit stressful because you want to get out and socialize with people, but hopefully things come together.
Right. So let's jump into topic for today.
Yeah. So today's topic, you guys, we are discussing, it's going to be about what's influencing your influencer.
Man, we just felt like with us taking that long hiatus, coming off that break, we needed to touch on this subject. Because I know you guys are aware, just as well as we are, that there's a lot of stuff going on social media right now.
Yes.
Right? There's a lot of things going on with influencers, relationships, and we just want to touch on it because we think it's very important for people to know what's influencing the influencers, right? Because I believe that sometimes we can be in a really dark spot in our life. Mm-hmm. Like we can be going through a lot of adversity and we're just looking for anything and anybody to help us get out of that darkness, right? So when we go on social media, we get captivated by, you know, the little snippets that people put on their Instagram page. And we feel like they have all the answers to our struggles, to our problems, and we buy into that person without knowing who they really are.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And as influencers, a lot of people like being teachers before they actually are the students. Mm. So although I guess they're trying to grow their brand, they're leading people down the wrong path, I believe. Mm-hmm. Because a lot of people live their lives filtered on social media, right? You think that their life is perfect. You think that their relationship is perfect, but behind closed doors, they're struggling just like you are.
Yeah.
So before you buy into people, I think it's very important that you do your research on them and figure out what's influencing them. Because a lot of people are influenced by money. A lot of people are influenced by fame. And if you're leading down that, if you're following somebody who's having those type of things lead them, they can take you down the wrong path with them. So what me and Asha wanted to do with this episode is really share what we value. So you guys know where we're coming from. Because like I say many of times, I don't ever want somebody to look up at our relationship and look down at yours because you think that we have it all figured out. Because we don't.
Not at all.
Right?
Not
you ain't
got
to do all
not
that.
Not even close.
A little bit. Listen, but we only been married 4 years. So there's no way that we're experts in marriage. Mm-hmm. Right? We told you before that we didn't see marriage growing up. Our parents weren't married. Well, my parents were married until I was three, but I don't really know too much about that.
Yeah.
So I didn't really get to see it. So there's no way that me and her could be an expert in something we only been doing for 4 years. So what we want this podcast to be is not a community where we're teaching you guys, we're the teachers and you're the students. What we want this podcast to be is a community full of students, people who just want to create a better relationship for themselves and their partner. So we're going to grow along with you. We're going to share some of the hardships that we face in our relationship, and we're going to share some of the things that we do to try to improve it and the things that we excel at. But we need y'all feedback just as much as y'all need ours so that we can all grow together.
Yeah. So what you touched on, let's talk about what you value. What are your values? Let's just say your top three.
My top three values, top three things that I value in my life right now in order is my family, God, and impact. And I know a lot of you who are watching this or listening to this is like, those are some really good values, but you got them in the wrong order. Like God is supposed to come first. And I'm gonna tell you right now, I completely agree with you. God should be number one in your life. However, I like to live in my truth. Having God number one in my life is something that I strive for. But currently right now, that's not my life, right? I'm on my faith walk, I'm on my journey, and I'm getting there. I'm trying to build a closer relationship with God so that I can not only say that he's the number one priority in my life, but you can look at me and see that he's the number one priority in my life. Because I feel like when you live in this facade, right? When you lie to yourself, when you're not living in your truth, then it's dangerous because you feel like you don't need to grow. You don't feel like that anything needs to change about you. Mm-hmm. So hopefully one day I can get on this podcast and say, look, my order is God, family, impact. But for right now, I can't say that God is number one in my life because I don't do everything in my power to build that close relationship with God so that I not only say it, but it shows. But like I said, my family is number one thing that I value in my life. Mm-hmm. I know if you follow me for a long time, you see the sacrifices that I made for my family. It's not something I just talk about. It's something that I live by. Because I remember when I was in college, before I got drafted, I remember Oprah saying something that changed my life when she was interviewing Dave Chappelle. And she was like, if you don't know who you are before the money and fame comes, then you'll never know who you are because you'll get lost. And that made me really sit down and figure out what I valued as a man, what I valued in my life and family was number one. As I already talked about my relationship with God and how I'm working to make him number one in my life. And the third one was just impact. I want to leave an impact so strong on this world that when I'm gone, you can't say that I never walked this earth, mm-hmm. right? I want people to know that I walked here. I want to leave a legacy for my family. I want to be able to help out as many people as I can, whether it's through my speeches, my book, this podcast, our foundation. I want to make sure that I leave an impact on this world.
Yeah, that's big.
What about you?
So I would say, yeah, I'm out
of breath.
I would say that ours is pretty similar. I would say mine's is God, family, and health, my family's health. Mm-hmm. And like you said, with you saying, you know, with putting God first, I think that's completely true. The reason why I say God first is because I feel like that is the foundation for life for me. I always talk to Devin. We always talk about, I say, trying to find, like, your purpose in life, or trying to find, like, just the true essence of life, like, just being fulfilled and being able to wake up and just be so thankful for, you know, the littlest things, like, just having this, like gratefulness, you know, about life. And I feel like that's something that I've been on the verge of trying to really have, just being like, you know what? You wake up and you just like, I'm just thankful for this tree right here. And it's just like, why? But it's just like, God planted this tree here and we need the oxygen, you know, just having that deep, like, just thankfulness and gratefulness about life. And I feel like God is the reason that we're all here. He's the reason why everything is the way it is. And that's why I say God first, because like you said, we are on that walk. I feel like I am on that walk with trying to have a better relationship and trying to be more committed and having a better understanding of my faith. But that does not stray me away from saying that God is first for me. The second thing, which is still my number one priority, but I would have to say second, is family, because family is very huge to me. I feel like it's always been very important to me. I have a very big family. So I just felt like, even growing up, I always knew that when I was to get older and have a family of my own, I would, you know,
with
just...
me?
Yes.
Don't act like that wasn't part of your dream as a little girl.
With you, okay, because I knew who I was going to marry, okay?
Yeah.
But I just knew that I wanted to have, you know, a family of my own. I wanted to have a certain... I always say three children just because my mom had three kids, but always wanted to have a big family.
Shout
and just
to
create these memories and these traditions and just, you know, have a close-knit family. So that's why I say it's very important. Family's always going to be very important to me, my top priority. And then health, especially now, because I feel like the way that the world has been in just a matter of months and just how crazy everything is, it's just like so scary. And like, we had, you know, health scares before, but like this time right now and everything being so unknown, it's just out of control. And I feel like just having great health and being in great health and doing everything you can possibly do to make sure that you're healthy so that you can hopefully avoid and overcome certain issues or certain things that may come your way, especially with the pandemic, is just like very important to me. So I feel like just with us being taking our health more serious and just being on our fitness, you know, journey and eating right and just trying to get better with all of that has been very crucial to me, because I've been seeing the change that I wanted to always see within myself, but also to avoid and hopefully prevent, you know, unnecessary things happening.
Yeah. And I think not only just being true with your values with yourself, but sharing it with your partner is very important.
Mm-hmm.
Understanding what your partner values in life so that you can support them. Because your values are basically your boundaries in a relationship, right?
Right.
You want to make sure that you don't cross those boundaries. You want to understand what that person values so that you make sure you stay in line with them and you support them. So I encourage everybody who's watching this or listening to this to sit down and really talk about this thing. Because how often do you really sit down and talk with your partner and find out what they value? Because things change over time.
That's true.
Right? And the person is continually growing and developing and, you know, just finding out new things about life. So it's so important to really sit down, especially during these times, and see what you guys value as individuals and what you want to value as a household and as a family.
Yeah, because I feel like, especially for us, I feel like in our 20s, like just from us getting together when we were in our younger 20s, that where I was and the things that I value are completely different.
Wild.
Wow. It's completely different. Like,
she done turned down on me, man.
I don't even know if I could give you that list. I'm still in my turn up phase. No, you ain't in no turn up phase. You better turn all the way down. But it is important for you to just have those conversations, because like you said, if you've been with your partner for quite some time and you know, things have occurred, y'all going through obstacles, like those values, those core values that you have for yourself, not even for your relationship, may have changed, and that may be affecting your relationship. So yeah, it's really important for you to have that discussion.
Yeah, I agree. Another thing that I think that we should get into is get into the good stuff. Let's have an honest moment. Mm-hmm. Like we told you guys, we don't have everything figured out in our marriage. Like, we're still working. So we just want to be open and honest with you guys right now to let you know. My bad, I'm all on your hair. Because you know that thing that got long, man. I can't just put my arm back there.
Or quarantine, I've been going my hair, you know. So
no, I think that we should. Sorry. I think there's some things that we should share that we struggle with. Okay. In our marriage. So what is something that you think that we struggle with, or what's something that you think that you can improve on as a wife to really help our marriage flourish?
Okay. We get into the nitty gritty.
I'm going to let y'all know if she lying too.
So I think you said one thing.
We only going to stick to one thing.
Okay.
The biggest thing.
Okay, so the biggest thing,
I mean, I'll tell you what it is if you want me to, if you're struggling.
I don't need you to tell me. I got it. But I think the biggest thing for me is accountability has been something that I feel like I've been working on with taking accountability for myself. with taking account, you know what? With taking accountability for my actions, like it'll be times where we'll have discussions, maybe turn into an argument, and it's just like a back and forth, and I'm so stern and set into what I'm saying and my way that it's just like, whatever he has to say, I'm not trying to hear it. Even if I know that it could possibly be right, I'm just like, you know
not
what?
Not possibly, but
it's not. It's not right. I'm right. You're wrong. Don't argue with me about it. I don't hear it. Like, just let it be. And so I had to realize and come to the understanding that, you know what? It may just be you sometimes, not all the time, but sometimes. So I realized that I have to take accountability for my actions and understanding, you know?
We need to do this podcast more often, because I thought I was going to have to reach out to Ayala on you. But it's like you be having your aha moments where in front of this microphone.
Oh, my gosh.
You just being honest.
I mean, I'm just trying to be real. You said
it's
real.
But it's on tape.
Yes.
It's on tape. So just make sure
but
you
I feel
keep
like
the
you,
same energy. No,
so
listen
you haven't
to me.
Been
this wasn't about me. This
that wasn't, I've been taking accountability for my actions here and there.
Here and there, but I need it everywhere.
Well, listen here. You got to start, okay? Start with baby steps.
No, we got a baby. You got to take adult steps.
No, you guys start with baby steps, okay? The first thing is admitting, okay?
That's
admitting
the hardest part.
And owning up to what you're doing wrong. Then we're going to take some baby steps, okay?
All right.
So what is yours? What do you feel like?
Feel like there's anything that I need
you
to work
lie.
On.
You a whole lie.
You think so?
You a whole lie.
Let me try to figure out something for you just to make you happy, just to make the listeners happy. Because I feel like I'm perfect.
Ooh, don't
that whole rant I was doing in the beginning, I was
he
talking
ain't
about
lying.
Asha.
He not lying. He think he is.
I think what I need to work on is being more of a listener and less of a problem solver. Because I think that a lot of the times when you come to me with issues, I try to solve them. I try to fix them. And I don't really listen to see what you want to do about it. Mm. Right? Like, you talked on a little bit earlier about your career change and you deciding to walk away from your career as a hair stylist and, you know, go back to school and make that decision. I know me and you went back and forth with it for a long time because I have a certain mindset towards life. Right, but I have to realize that everybody is on a different journey. Even if we're together in a relationship, you have your own personal journey that you're going on. You have a awakening that you have to go through.
Right.
And I need to be there to support that. Whether you crash and burn or you succeed, I need to be your ride or die. I mean, I don't think that you're going to crash and burn, but whatever the case may be, I need to be there with you supporting you. And then whatever arises, we'll make it through together. So that's something I definitely need to work on. And you've been in.
Okay. No, that, I can appreciate that. And that is true. I feel like you have been doing that. That's a huge improvement on your part. So I think that's a real honest moment from you right there.
Thank you.
So I feel like with our topic being what's influencing your influencer, with us, I guess, being influencers, I never really seen myself as an influencer. Like, I feel like an influencer, like the title is so loosely used nowadays. It's like anybody can be an influencer. And it's just like, what exactly is an influencer? You know what I mean? And so I noticed, just for me, because of course, you know, you are a Devin Steele, former athlete, you know, all of these great things, speaker, author. So you're so used to being in that limelight and being in that influencer position. And with me, it's just like, yeah, you know, that just came with being the wife of an NFL player at the time, which is how people know our story.
But I don't consider myself an influencer either. Like I said, I'm all about impact.
Yeah.
And I want to live, I want to impact people by the way I live my life, not the things that I say.
Yeah.
But you can continue. I don't consider myself an influencer either because everybody influencer nowadays.
But I mean, I don't think that's a bad thing necessarily, you know, because it's just like certain people have things that they, you know, are great attributes and traits and they want to be able to share it, and it does influence other people's lives. So I feel like with people seeing or looking at you as an influencer, it's not necessarily a bad thing, but it's just like, I personally, I'm much more reserved than you, I would say. So I am discreet with certain things. I share what I feel like I want to share. And so just using the title influencer is just like, I don't know so much about it. I kind of tiptoe around that because it's just like, I feel like people expect a lot from you when you are that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's just like, for me, I want to kind of pose the question, like, what, with having to be an influencer, it takes a lot out of you, right? Because you got to produce this content. You got to give so much to individuals. You got to be able to share so much of your life. And it can be draining. So what do you feel like helps you, in a sense, to pour back into you when you're constantly giving out so much?
Because just being in that influencer space, I've always told myself to never lose myself to try to gain the attention of other people. And I think that's what a lot of people are losing it right now, where they just doing as much as they can to gain the attention of people on social media, to grow their following, that they lose their core values. They lose their true identity, and they struggle with it, right? A lot of these people who you think are living their life online, like I said, it's filtered. So what I love to do is just to always pour into myself, to really focus on my well-being, both mental and physical well-being. So like I touched on earlier, a lot of things that I do to pour in myself is to work out, because I understand the health benefits that come with working out. Another thing I do is constantly learn. I'm always trying to get better. I just recently graduated with my master's in leadership in December. Go ahead, snap.
Okay.
And then I just went back to school at the University of Penn to get a degree in applied positive psychology, so that I'm not just out here saying snippets that sound good, but I understand how people can really flourish in their life, how they can flourish in their relationship. So just doing those things, making sure that I'm continually growing, I'm actually having an impact on people's lives, is a way that I pour into myself.
Okay. What about you? An educated man, okay? I'm
trying to be.
I would say just getting to know myself more. Like I said, kind of like shameless plug, go check out my YouTube at Asha Steele.
Ain't no shame in this game.
But I feel like just trying to pour into myself and be able to, you know, give certain content that I want to be able to share. So like I said, I've always, even before I found out that I was pregnant, we talked about, we had like wrote our little vision boards, and I wanted to be on this journey of a little mommy blogger and post out certain content and everything like that and sharing my experiences. So when I did get pregnant, it was kind of like, I wasn't ready, y'all. Okay. It was a whole new experience for me. It was a lot that went into it. Just a huge adjustment. So the idea that I had in my mind or what I was going to be doing didn't quite go out that way. So I kind of felt like I need to pour back into myself and get back to what it is that Asha wants. So there, i.e. my career change, just putting out certain content that I value and enjoy and want to be able to share with others, has been something that helps me to be able to, you know, pour back into me. Because it's not just about, you know, what's good for others, is what's good for you. You know, what is making you happy? So I don't want to always be giving out so much that I'm just like just trying to find things and force things just to be able to give out content. It's something that
you can't pour from an empty cup.
Right. So it's like what fills me up? What makes me happy so that I can share something genuine with y'all that I'm excited about? So that's something that I've been working on, and that's what's been filling me up.
Yeah, just hearing you touch on that, it just brought up, because I know earlier we talked about some of the things that we can improve on. And I talked about doing the biggest thing that we can do. And I don't think what I said was the biggest thing. Now that you just touched on that. Like you said, that you said you wasn't ready to have a child with everything that you was trying to do in your life. And I think that one of the things that I can do to better support that is stepping up and doing more around the house, especially, you know, with Aria.
Yes.
Although I can't just whip out my boob and feed her, there's other things that I can do to really take some of the responsibility away from you. Because like I told you guys before, a lot of times my main focus is just making sure we got a roof over our head, that our finances is straight. So my mind is always on the go, always trying to find ways to provide for my family. And you take on a lot of the responsibilities around the house, whether it's like cleaning and cooking and taking care of the kids. And I feel like I need to step up in that area of not cooking, because I do my thing in the kitchen.
Yeah, you do. Throw down.
But just helping take care of Aria so that you can really focus on your dreams and aspirations. And like I said, we just have to support each other and along this journey that we're going on.
Yes, Bill. I appreciate that.
Man, I just got to be honest, because you know a lot of men out there probably going go with the easiest thing they can say to their woman, but you really got to be honest with yourself if you want to grow. So there are things that I definitely need to work on. I know a lot of people see me on Instagram like, he got a brother, he got a twin or something, but man, I got my baggage.
Yeah, but you know,
No.
We unpacking.
You're not supposed to say yeah.
Yeah, but we unpacking the baggage, you know. We
it's
unpacking,
you know,
we unpacking
make
it.
Make you take one book bag. That's the type of baggage I got. I ain't got the suitcases, though.
It's a heavy large load. Large book bag. A large book bag, okay? But we unpacking it, and it's fine, you know. I feel like this is a moment of, you know, especially this time, it's just a moment of being able to have, you know, all of mental clarity, be able to adjust and adapt and change a lot of things in your life that have been, you know, bothering you, and just going on a new verge of life, just taking on new experiences, new opportunities, and having that therapy that you need to have to relieve a lot of things. So we working on it.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'm excited that we've finally been able to get in an episode. Aria still sleep. I swear to
you. Okay. Thank
you. Cereal.
That cereal was everything. Okay.
So we are going to be pushing these episodes out, because I'm just going to keep feeding her that cereal.
Okay. You're not going to feed it to her all the time.
I'm going to feed it to her all the time. My parents did it to me, and look what happened to me. I grew up a healthy baby.
You know what?
Successful and everything. So she going to eat this cereal so we can do what we got to do. Especially having, you know, mommy and daddy time. Because she be blocking.
You know what? But you guys.
Ooh, listen to me. Listen to me. If y'all follow me on Instagram, still in the game, plug. Listen to me. I put up a picture the other day of Aria in our bed because she didn't want to go sleep by herself, because they be doing this co-sleeping thing. So I don't get no alone time. And every time I try to get alone time.
You do get alone time.
Aria be blocking harder than Shaq. So now that I see that this cereal worked, every night she's eating cereal and she's getting out.
Okay. We going to do a transition.
No, she getting out.
A transition into her room. But you guys, we just wanted to come on here and give y'all this content. Like we said, we are going to try our absolute best, no excuses, to give y'all the content that y'all been asking for, because we've been getting a lot of comments and DMs like, where is the next podcast? We're waiting. So we apologize once again, you guys, but we are going to make sure that we are going to be transparent with you all, be honest about, you know, everything that we're experiencing in life and put this content out there. If y'all have anything that y'all want to hear about, if y'all have any topics that y'all want to discuss, I know I had a few people that, you know, send over a few topics. So we will be getting on that and making those podcasts. But if y'all want to talk about some, relieve y'all stresses, want to give us some advice so that we can give y'all advice, make sure y'all send us an email, give us a DM, a comment, anything, and let us know so that we can get on it and produce that content for y'all.
Yeah, our email is questions@realrelationshipspodcast.com. And what's our Instagram?
Real Relationships Podcast. Make sure y'all check it out on Instagram and make sure y'all check out our website as well.
And fellas, ladies can do this too, but fellas, check out our website, realrelationshipspodcast.com. Mm-hmm. I created, well, I'm about to put it up now. I'm talking about go check out the website. I'm about to put it up as soon as we get off this podcast, but go to our website, realrelationshipspodcast.com. I created these massage certificates, gift certificates that you can print out. Don't go get one.
I might need one. No.
Listen, I'm She's talking still to
sleep.
Them right
I
now.
I need one. She's still asleep. Let me cash in.
Go there and print out the massage certificates that I developed and made and give it to your woman. I think you can print out as many as you want to, but it allows them to pick what type of massage they want, how long for. And, you know, you never know what that'll lead to. So, fellas, go print out those massage tickets and give it to your lady and just try it out. Try to use this as a way to build that connection as we go through these tough times.
Yeah. And ladies, you can do it too. Okay. Don't be no shame in the game, you know, because you got to treat each other right. Mm-hmm. So, yes, make sure y'all check it out because I think I'm about to cash it in as long as Aria stays asleep.
I hear you.
Okay.
I'm going to print me out. So we're going to cash it in together.
Oh, my goodness. So until next time, you guys, keep it real.
Yes, sir.